Hey, I'm Del Shanzi, and I'm here with Super Troy, awesome pilot. And we're talking about the 304 reasons the flat top is the only paramotor that competent people buy or fly. So we'll get started here. Trigger throttle for easy, non-taxing finger operation. So the trigger throttle has a very nice, gentle spring, so your finger doesn't take so much pressure. A lot of these guys have this huge bicycle brake throttle, and they take a lot more physical exertion, and your fingers get tired after flying, just not for very long. Where this, you can fly for hours without your finger just killing you by the end of it. So it's nice to have that nice trigger throttle. Small, unobtrusive trigger throttle to help prevent accidental full throttle in case of fall or crash. So if you trip and fall down and you got a big old bicycle brake throttle, what's going to be the first thing you land on? That's right, your throttle. So not only do other units explode on top of you, but they do it while you're full throttle because you just fell down and landed on the throttle. So very, very nice to have a nice slim trigger throttle so it's not going to be landed on. Very, very important. Snag-free trigger throttle assembly helps prevent loss of control from accidental snagging of lines, harnesses, clothing, radio wires, and other objects. Very, very important. So there's a guy, there's actually a YouTube video on this. You can look it up. And he broke his back on a fresh breeze because of the stupid piece of crap throttle. And of course, they have totally uncertified height hook-in points. So the guy took a collapse and all of a sudden, smacked up and boom, his bicycle brake throttle stuck in the risers. The risers twisted up and locked his throttle wide open. And now he's facing backwards to the direction the glider is facing. Thrust goes one way, glider dives straight at the ground. He spiraled in and he was only saved. Luckily, his glider hit a telephone pole, a big, huge pole, and it snagged the glider. So luckily he only broke his back. But bicycle brake throttles are just stupid. You just don't do it in this sport. It's dumb. You don't want it there. Plus, every time you go to take off, you've got to manipulate the risers, your brake lines, clothing, wires, this and that. You cannot have this big, huge brake throttle that's gonna get snagged on lines. See, even you, have you ever had a problem doing forward launch or reverse? You lift it up, no problems. You just don't have those issues with the flat top because it's designed by people that know what the heck they're doing. So very, very, very important to have the throttle, you know, set up properly. Single trigger throttle, free rest up hands to operate toggles. Okay, another thing about having a nice trigger throttle that's simple to operate is it leaves your three fingers wide open for your brake toggle. That gives you a lot more power in your hand and a better feel and precision for being able to control everything at the same time. So with the brake or whatever in your hand, you can still operate the throttle piece of cake with two fingers. Grip it with the thumb and this one here. So makes it a lot easier, snag free, and you're not having those issues. Grip safety only allows throttle to be actuated when gripping throttle assembly to prevent throttle. We've all trip and fall down because it's part of the sport. Have you ever had your motor go full throttle when you fall down? Not once. Grip safety, back of the throttle. If you fall down and you put your hands out to catch yourself, as soon as you disengage that grip safety, you cannot push the trigger. Safety issue. So you trip and fall down, we don't want you full throttle, you know, with a prop on top of your back. So very, very important. Trigger mechanicals are optimized for a longer trigger pull to ensure a full throw on carburetor throttle. Some of the trigger throttles, you do have to be careful because they might not actuate your throttle all the way. So these are specially designed so that you get a full actuation of the throttle rocker arm where you're getting all the way from full throttle all the way back to idle. You just have a longer throw. Custom cable housing bracket designed for minimal weight. The throttle cable, even the way it's installed, everything needs to make a smooth, gentle arc. Having raced bicycles, I know all too well about how to route your throttle cables and the angles that you want those cables at or don't want those cable housings at. lot of people put those angles too tight trying to get into tight spaces. And if you've got a tight kink in your cable, it makes it a lot harder and rougher to operate your throttle. So the flat top has a really nice simplified design. Plus we're using the highest top of the line Jaguar throttle cable housing, as well as a super slick pre-stretch throttle cable that comes from high-end bicycles. So you have the smoothest with no gritty, grindy feel to your throttle. It just feels nice and smooth like a $10,000 bicycle. Mine weighed 14.5 pounds, so it had all the best stuff on it. And of course, from bicycles, I'm kind of a weight weenie, which means, that's a bicycle term, mean we want the absolute lightest gear without sacrificing strength or safety. And that's why the flat top is so light. Very, very important, because that's the goal. Custom cable housing bracket, minimal weight for mass. Just the way we attach it to the carburetor, we modify and make custom attachments to make sure everything runs free and correct. Another little thing that we do is we use a glue heat shrink to heat shrink the throttle cable housing to the barrel adjuster. Other units, if you don't have that and you accidentally pull your throttle cable, it can pop out of that barrel adjuster and lock you at almost full throttle of the motor. And a lot of people have been seriously injured because of that. So again, the flat top, we do everything we can, right down to all those little small things, to make sure that you have the absolute safest setup possible on the market. Okay, here we go. Some other things with the throttle is, let's see here. Trigger mechanism operating for longer throttle pull. Okay, all right, another thing, we're gonna get away from the throttle for a second, is the motor mounting plate on the engine. We mount the engine to the plate, and then the plate is mounted to the engine. The motor mounting, or the motor mounts, vibration mounts, go in between the plate and the frame. A lot of the units do not have that. They mount their engine directly to the frame. Well, think about it. You got a high horsepower, high torque engine, two-stroke, and you're getting vibration in that engine. Well, that vibration is trying to tear their frame apart. That's why you have fresh breezes with so many cracks and other paramotors where the frames are cracking and having major issues, that and the fact that they're not heat treated where the flat top is. So the flat top frame is heat treated after welding, bringing it back to T6. So lots of little things like that. Also, by having that motor mounting plate, it allows you to change to any engine. So if a new engine comes out, we'll just make a mounting plate and you can just adapt that engine right to your flat top frame and cage. So you could literally change engines with four bolts and a couple of tie wraps and you have a whole new power plant on your flat top. Very, very cool. Improves reliability, allows you to adjust how the angle of the engine is so you can get the minimal amount of torque, which is one of the reasons it has the least torque. And of course, we spend an enormous amount of time testing engines to make sure we use the absolute best engines. So you have the lightest, most powerful, and most reliable engine that's also the quietest and has the least vibration, even though any two-stroke is going to have vibration. Or any engine, period. Custom machine, engine mounting plate, centers. Centers, motor mounts for aesthetically pleasing look. And with the motor mounts, again, the engine mounts to a plate. Now, if you look at the engine, those motor mounts are only about 6 inches apart. So if you put the rubber vibration dampening and you have rubber motor mounts that are only 6 inches apart, any flex and that prop can flex up and down. It's another reason that if you so much as barely bump a unit like a Scout, the engine will flex, the whole prop will move and chop the whole unit up, and the whole unit catastrophically self-destructs. So you do not want your engine's mounts only 6 inches apart. So we mount the engine to the plate, then the plate mounts to the frame. So your motor mounts are over twice as far apart. So the unit is a lot stiffer. A huge, gigantic improvement. So if you smack in the skids on a flat top, you're not gonna have that prop flexing clear up anywhere near as easily, it has made a drastic difference in the strength and reliability. And it's things like this you would never think about when you're getting into the sport. That's why it's so critical to look at the skill level of who the heck you're talking to. I'm not gonna put my kids on some piece of crap air conception that so many people have been injured on and killed. It's just stupid. It's hard to even comprehend. It's like trying to explain why someone would vote for Hillary. There is no logic. There is no reason or rational thought process to these people. They literally do not care about your life. So it's important, look at the skill level and competency of who you're talking about. Okie dokie. Custom machine engine mounting plate drilled with custom holes, stators, throttle. Okay, so the way we wire everything and mount everything works extremely well. It allows you to work on the engine very easily. You move the frame, the harness, and everything's right there, so you have easy access to it. Plus, you do have that access port, which we talked about in another video, which allows you to get to your carburetor in flight, which you don't have on other units. And that is page 13 of the 304 reasons competent pilots only fly flat tops. After all, how could you call yourself competent if you're putting people on a unit that over 100 people have been shredded in the prop with, and it's never even been updated for safety? So no, you can't be considered competent if you're using horribly unsafe gear. That's why competent pilots all fly flat tops. So see you next time, 304 reasons, flat tops the only one.